Give us your take right now on whether this makes a difference to investors, and if so, how?
Well, I think we need to sit back and take a look. There's three potential coalitions that get built here. As we all know, German politics is very aware of the coalition model. So first you have the Social Democrats. They came in with very strong performance. They were the leader in the election, but only by a slight amount. You then have the Christian Democrats behind them. Both of these parties are looking to form coalitions with both the Greens and the Liberals. So you could have either of those coalitions. The final one, which could be a slight surprise, is that we go back to the former grand coalition of the past that we've seen.
There could be a so-called grand coalition between the two main parties.
That is a possibility here, and it would mean more of the same. You've had an end to a phenomenal reign of Angela Merkel. She has been, in her role for almost 16 years, and that is one of the coalitions that hasn't been talked about. But when we talk about all of the coalitions, because during the election, the extreme leftist party lost support, got under that 5% level that was critical, and the extreme right actually also lost support, what you're seeing in Europe is now a lower risk of some of these extreme populist outcomes. So I think Europe and Germany being a big leader in Europe is kind of in a Goldilocks position from a political point of view.
Well, and let me come back. You said we'll have more of the same if we have the Grand Coalition. Are we likely to have much of more of the same, even if the SPD or the CDU-CSU get to rule it? Because they're pretty centrist, aren't they? Are they really different?
They're not too different. I think that they like to emphasize their differences more than telling people they're the same. I think the Social Democrats want to roll back some of the labor reforms that you saw under Schroeder. I then think if they partner with the Greens, which seems very, very likely for either the Christian Democrats or the Social Democrats would need to partner with the Greens, you will see a continuation of investment into green policy in Europe. But that's nothing to be surprised about. Europe is ahead of the curve. It's way ahead of the United States. And Germany is the real pillar of renewables investment. And I think that that will continue with the green agenda.
Katrina, what about the broader issue of German leadership of Europe? Because we certainly have had that under Angela Merkel. Have we lost that almost no matter what happens with these various coalitions?
I think the fact that we've got the FDP potentially going into the coalition with the SPD, you're going to have continued and increasing integration of Europe. And the more you have that integration, the more important Germany becomes in terms of its leadership role. I think that you've got a lot of great things in Europe that are going on, and U.S. investors just aren't aware of it. You look at some of the leadership that they've taken on the European Recovery Fund. I talked about the green agenda in Germany, but within the European Union, there is a very strong green agenda that is investing into renewables. It's investing into green transportation and rail networks. There are so many things that are going on and so many areas where Europe is showing such a leadership position. And I think sometimes the United States should look over the pond and admire what they're doing.
Will Germany, and if Germany is leading Europe lead in terms of growth?
I don't think that they can. I think that the U.S., obviously this year is a strong year. I know that the comments came out that people are expecting next year to slow, but Europe has always been a much slower growth economy. It doesn't have the same tech representation that we do and that same entrepreneurial innovation. What I think, however, is the gap between the U.S. growth rate and the European growth rate will close. You want to look at it as having a base level of normal European growth that's supplemented in 2022 and 2023 by the spending from the European Recovery Fund. A lot of that money is going into economies such as Italy, which really suffered under the pandemic. It now has Draghi leading the government there. It's fixing a lot of the legacy problems. So I think that while Europe may not surpass the U.S. in terms of growth, it's catching up quickly.